So as we're preparing our data to train models, we do have to make sure that the data we're working with doesn't have missing values, which can cause issues, and actually when you try to train a model might give you an error. And we also need to deal with duplicate rows, because duplicate rows can skew the result when you're training data models. So now let's take a look at, inside our actual code, using Python and Pandas data frame methods, how we can handle missing values and duplicates. So taking a look here, we're still working with Pandas data frames, so I'm going to import that wonderful Pandas library. And I'm going to start by loading a nice data set here into our data frame, which contains all sorts of information about different flights that have come and left and arrival delay information. Now, this is a very big data frame, and I do not want to go reading through every single row to find out which rows might have a duplicate value. But fortunately, I can use the DataFrame's info method. And what that will do is it will tell me all sorts of great information about that data frame and of the data inside it. So it tells me things like, hey, you have 300,000 rows inside that data frame across 16 different columns. And it also tells me how many, for each column, how many rows contain actual values, non-null values. So I can see that flight date has 300,000 rows, all containing non-null values, unique carrier, all the rows contain non-null values. But when you get to tail number, you'll notice only about 299,000 of the rows contain non-nulls. Or for arrival time, but again, there's a number of records here. Most of the rows have a non-null value, but that must mean that some of them do have a null value. So this is a simple way to check and see if you have any rows which contain a null value, or any particular columns that contain null values inside your data frame. So now that I've identified I do have rows with missing values, nulls, NANs, these words can be used interchangeably here, how do I handle that? So if we go back to our code, once you've identified it, you can use the drop NA, and what that will do is it will drop the rows with missing values. Now, by default, this does not modify the delays data frame itself. Instead, what I'm doing is I'm saying drop missing rows, rows with missing values, sorry, and take those rows, the remaining rows, and put them into a new data frame. So if I run this, and then I do an info on the new data frame, you'll see it only has 295,000 rows left, because all the rows with missing values have been removed. But you can see that every single column, all of the rows contain actual values. So I can confirm that I have successfully dropped every missing value, or every row with a missing value, from my data frame. If, however, you prefer not to create a new data frame, if you just want to drop the missing rows from the existing data frame, DelaysDF, you can do that too. That's supported. There's a function called, or a parameter called inPlace equals true when you set it to true. Basically, that's saying modify the delays data frame itself. So now what I've done is I've actually dropped the missing rows from the delays data frame. So you can see, once again, now it only has 295,000 rows, but every single one of the columns, all the values in there have no missing values, no nulls. The other scenario we sometimes have to deal with is duplicate values. So one of the things you'll find is sometimes when you're doing data science that data may come in from multiple files and then all be merged together into one data frame. So as a result, you can end up with some duplicate rows. And that can skew results when you start doing data science. So one of the things we need to do is A, check if there's duplicates, and then deal with them. So I'm just going to import a very small file here so that you can see it has duplicate values. So it has three records from USA. Those aren't duplicates. They just happen to be in the same country. But here, I can see that there's actually two records from Dulles, Washington. Now, I've deliberately displayed a very small data frame here so you can see that. But what if the data frame was too big to just show on the screen? How could I quickly just check and say, hey, look at all the rows and tell me if it's duplicates? Well, the Pandas data frame has this duplicated method. And what that will do is it'll return a true or false, indicating whether or not a row is a duplicate of a previous row. So in this case, the third row, this one here, 2, Dulles, Washington, is a duplicate of the previous row. So you can see that the one with the index of 2, it says, yes, that row is in fact a duplicate. It does have to be the entire row if it's a duplicate. Simply having the same value in a column does not make it a duplicate row. Once you've identified you do have duplicates, if you want to get rid of those, all you need to do is call drop duplicates. I'm using that same parameter in place equal true to say drop the duplicate rows inside the airport's data frame itself. So now when I run, you can actually see I've successfully gotten rid of that extra Dulles, Washington record. You will notice, of course, that index number that can cause gaps in your indexes. So just be aware of that as well when you're duplicating or dropping duplicate rows. So there we have it. We can figure out if we have any missing values in our data frame, get rid of the rows that do have missing values. We can determine if we do have any duplicate rows, and we can get rid of those duplicate rows. So now you've got your data a little more cleaned up and ready for data science and training models.